Good morning, students. In second year, in semester 3, we have a paper titled Statistical Methods. So this is the textbook you can follow of Kalyani Publishers, Statistical Methods. Okay, in which in the statistical methods we have 5 topics in 5 units: correlation, regression, and remaining topics of regression, correlation, ratio, partial correlation, multiple correlation, etc. And curve fitting, theory of attributes, and exact sampling distributions. These are the topics we have in the study of statistical methods. Today we discuss correlation. What is meant by correlation? What is the definition of correlation? Correlation means relation, simply relation between two variables. Which means we are using a bivariate data. It's a kind of bivariate distribution. A distribution deals with two variables. We have studied at the end of the one semester in the first year random variables, bivariate random variables, the concept of bivariate distribution, bivariate probability distributions. We have studied joint probability density function, joint probability mass function for discrete random variable and continuous random variables. We have studied the concept of bivariate, marginal density functions, conditional density functions, distribution functions, marginal distribution functions, conditional distribution functions, etc. But of course, not much of theory here required, just only the relation. If you remember that it is a bivariate analysis, because it has this consists of two particular variables, the relation between two variables is known as correlation. The definition is a simple definition of relation between two variables is known as correlation. Alright, in correlation, another definition also we have: the change of one variable affects the change of the other variable. This is another definition of correlation. What is that? The change of one variable affects the change of the other variable. For example, you have two variables x and y. The change of the variable x affects change of variable y. And such kind of relation is known as correlation. I give you an example. If you consider income and expenditure of group of families, let it be x, let it be y, the variable y, then if you specify this example, then what is the relation between income and expenditure? If income increases, expenditure increases. There is one kind of relation. It depends on, expenditure depends on income, the variable income. Your expenditure, that person's expenditure depends on the person's income. Depends on income levels, income of the person. Similarly, the expenditure of a family depends on the income of the family. So therefore these two are related. Such kind of variables are related variables, are known as related variables. And the type of relation is said to be correlation. Such kind of relation between the two variables is known as correlation. Correlation is nothing but relation between two variables. So we are discussing the bivariate concepts. We are discussing the bivariate data, bivariate distribution. The relation between two variables is nothing but correlation. We have many number of examples. I tell you on the various types of correlations. Now, what are the kinds? What are the types of correlation? There are two types of correlation. One, positive correlation. Two, negative correlation. Correlation is of two types, positive correlation and negative correlation. When do you say correlation is positive correlation and the correlation is a negative correlation? Positive correlation in the sense that if one variable increases in one direction, if one variable increases, other variable also increases. If one variable decreases, the other variable also decreases. Which means, if one variable changes in one direction, other variable also changes in the same direction. That is, if x increases, one variable increases, the other variable also should increase. Similarly, one variable decreases, other variable also should be decreased. The same direction, change will be in the same direction. Change is observed in the same direction. Now come to the examples of this positive correlation. If one variable, for example, income and expenditure, the same example if you consider. Income and expenditure of a group of families. So usually if income of a group of family or a family increases, automatically expenditure also increases. Vice versa, obviously vice versa for this example. If income decreases, expenditure must decrease. There's no way. If income decreases, expenditure must decrease as economically and as practically is going to be considered. No other way to consider it. So therefore, for example, you consider in the increasing direction. If income increases, expenditure also increases. This is the one example. Similarly, I consider heights and weights. Of a competitor who participate in a competition, for example, are usually in a particular phenomena that in the humankind, if you humankind relation, if height increases, if a particular person, the height of a particular person increases, automatically weight also usually increases. It's a usual pattern we are observing. And don't consider the reverse relation. Height decreases, weight decreases. No, not like that. So because of height is not possible to decrease, right? So limited. So if height increases, weight also of a particular person, of a group of person also, in a particular competition also going to be increased. Hope you are able to follow these examples. Alright, similarly, demand and supply. If we go for another example. Demand and supply. If demand increases, supply also increases. You can consider the reverse relation. If demand decreases, supply also definitely should decrease. If demand increases, demand of a commodity, of an item, of a component. Okay? If demand of a component, demand of an item, commodity is going to be, if increases, then supply also increases. It's a usual relation in economical situations. If demand increases, obviously there is no choice for the producer or entrepreneur, obviously it also come down. Supply also come down. So these kinds of relation, that is, if one variable increases, other variable also increases. If one variable decreases, the other variable also decreases. That is, if one variable changes one proportionately in one direction, the other variable also changes in the same direction. And such kind of relation, correlation, is called positive correlation. Are you able to understand the concept? It's a very simple concept. Next, negative correlation. What is meant by a negative correlation? Negative correlation. If one variable increases, the other variable should decrease. Similarly, if one variable decreases, other variable increases. That is, if x increases, then y should decrease. Similarly, if x decreases, y should increase. That is, the change in one variable is in one direction, the change in the other variable must be in the another direction. The change of the one variable is in one direction, then the change of the other variable in another direction, opposite direction. And such kind of correlation, the correlation is called negative correlation. It's very, very simple definition you can write. Such kind of correlation is called negative correlation. What are the examples? Volume and pressure of a gas. If volume increases, pressure decreases. If volume decreases, pressure is going to be increased. Of a particular gas, if you observe, if volume increases, pressure decreases. If volume decreases, pressure increases. This is one kind of example. Another example, the price and demand. If price decreases, then demand increases. That's the usual pattern. The price of a commodity decreases, then demand increases. If price increases, then demand decreases of a commodity. If price of a commodity increases, then demand of a commodity usually decreases. If price is more of a particular commodity, then demand will decrease. It is an obvious pattern in the economic situation. Similarly, vice versa. So that is, the change of one variable is in one direction, the change of the other variable is in opposite direction. And such kind of correlation is known as negative correlation. These are the two types of correlation, positive and negative correlations. But another kind of relation is also there, that is called uncorrelation. This is not comes under this particular category, but you can write in the examination. That is called uncorrelation. That is, there is no relation between the two variables. It's called uncorrelation. That is, the variables are said to be uncorrelated variables. Uncorrelation. If one variable changes, it does not affect the change of the other variable. And such kind of relation, exactly to specify, such kind of no relation is said to be uncorrelation. Not having any relation between the two variables is known as uncorrelation. Where variables are said to be uncorrelated variables. That is the actual terminology. Uncorrelated variables. uncorrelated variables. The variables are said to be uncorrelated variables. Examples, many examples you can give, right? The height of the father and age of the son. Not exactly. There is no relation between the height of the father and the age of the son. Like some variables, the meaning of the variables has no meaning. The meaning of the variables will not be present over there. There will not be a relation. There is not be no exact meaning of that particular relation. And such kind of relation, such kind of non-relation, not related variables are said to be uncorrelated variables. That is, the relation between the two variables is zero. Okay, zero as the measure is to be considered. So therefore, there is no kind of relation between the two particular variables which are said to be uncorrelated variables. Which are said to be uncorrelated variables. So these are the types of correlation. One, in this lesson we have discussed the first one, correlation, definition of correlation. Second one, types of correlation, in which we have discussed the definitions of positive correlation, negative correlation, and also we have discussed the uncorrelation, that is uncorrelated variables. So this is the topic, correlation, definition and types of correlation. Hope you understand. Hope you are able to follow these concepts. This is the definition of correlation and types of correlation. Thank you.